This is question number two. We're told that a sequence is defined by the recurrence relation un plus 1 equals 0.3 times un plus 5 with the first term u1. Part A, it says, explain why this sequence has a limit as n tends to infinity. Well, if you remember the rules of recurrence relations, any recurrence relation will have a limit if A lies between 1 and minus 1. So A is the multiplier, 0.3. So 0.3 does in fact lie between 1 and minus 1. So that means that this recurrence relation will tend to a limit. Part B says find the exact value of this limit. So in order to work out the limit, we use the limit formula. So L, the limit, equals B divided by 1 minus A, where A is this number 0.3, the multiplier, and B is the number on the end. So our limit is 5 divided by 1 minus A, which is 1 minus 0.3, and that gives us 5 over 0.7. So if we divide that through with a calculator, on our calculator screen we got lots of decimal places. In fact, it fills up the whole calculator screen. So if we use that number, then that's not an exact value. The only way to express this as an exact value is to leave it as a fraction. So at the moment we have 5 over 0.7, which isn't really the way we want to leave it. The fact that there's a decimal on the bottom isn't very good. So what we should do at this moment is multiply by 10 on the top and on the bottom. So the fraction stays equivalent, but what we have is a new fraction without any decimal on the bottom line. So multiplying the top line by 10 gives us 50. And multiplying the bottom line by 10 gives us 7. So what we have now is an exact value for our answer. We don't have a decimal, so 50 over 7 is our final answer. We know that this is a top-heavy fraction, so if we wanted to express it as a mixed number, we could do that also. 7 goes into 50 7 times. 7 sevens are 49. So 7 goes into 50 7 times, which leaves 1 seventh as well. So 50 over 7 expressed as a mixed number is 7 and 1 seventh. Either of those would be fine as our final answer.